What if we might actually damage our child's relationship with learning by an overexuberance for planning all of the fun activities? Hi, I'm Rachel from 7 in All, and today I'm going to be talking with you some thoughts about why you don't have to worry about always making learning so fun. And I want to kind of credit Wendy from Plan, Prep, Pray for this video idea, because she suggested, if you have watched my channel for a while, you'll know that our family and my way of thinking, it tends to operate a little bit differently from the norm. And she encouraged me to lean into that and, you know, show some of my thoughts on some issues, even if they're different from what is popular or trendy. So if you don't like this video, you can go tell her. you can blame Wendy for this video. Just kidding, she's awesome. She's got a great channel. If you wanna learn how to be productive in your homeschool, definitely go and head to her channel. She's so encouraging and such a joy to watch. But if you wanna hear why I don't think that you should necessarily prioritize always having fun in your homeschool, then you can stick around and watch me. All right, I am here to tell you today, you do not need to be bending over backwards, doing everything you can, trying to make learning fun for your child, trying to make the homeschool experience fun. I think sometimes we can be crippling ourselves and our kids by thinking, my child is only going to enjoy learning and thrive in learning if I find ways to make it fun. So we make sure that we do all the hands-on science experiments, and we add crafts to our history, and we make sure to go on field trips, and we do videos because kids love it when you turn on the videos during learning. And we do anything except, you know, just sit around reading books and completing some projects, because that would be too boring, and then our kids are not going to be having fun all the time, and we wouldn't want that. I want to try to shift your thinking a little bit here. I'm going to give you two big reasons why I believe we don't need to be constantly focusing and planning on how to have fun in our homeschools. Number one, what if we started expecting that our children would find learning fun? Learning itself, the process of knowing something. What if they found it fun to know things, not just the Instagrammable activities, but our kids were able to see value in learning just intrinsically, intrinsic value in learning. And this could be a hard shift if you already have older kids, but especially with younger kids, I would really recommend that you be a cheerleader and be enthusiastic for learning itself, not just for glamorous activities that you can put together and put on Instagram, but on, hey, you learned something. This morning, you didn't know that the letter L said L, but now you do. That is awesome. You know something that you didn't used to know. What if we celebrated in our homeschools, not necessarily that we did a really cool activity, although those are fun, but we celebrated that we get to wake up, we get to learn new stuff, and we get to go to bed knowing something that we didn't know the day before. What if we celebrated having new skills? I learned how to do something that I couldn't previously do. I didn't know how to start the laundry correctly, and now I know how to start the laundry. That's awesome. That is something great. We want our kids to value having skills. We want our kids to value knowing stuff, not only when it's fun. Not all skills are fun. Not all things that you learn are going to be the most exciting, but it's still very valuable. So consider that just in your planning. Is an overemphasis on fun starting to make both me and my kids think, oh, learning's only gonna be fun if I, you know, make sure we put some get up and dance into it, or if we do a craft, or if we watch a video about it, then it's gonna be fun, and it's just gonna be dry and boring if we just learn something without the extras. You know, honestly, looking back at my homeschool experience, many of my best memories are just sitting around reading books and having discussions about books with my mom and all my siblings. It was not like, we definitely did some exciting things once in a while, and most of them were probably planned by me and my siblings, not really by my mom. So they were more child-instigated experiments and projects. But I had so much fun just simply learning with my family because we were discovering new things. We were growing our brains. We were growing our skills. And it didn't have to be all so exciting. I think in the modern social media homeschooling world, there can be so much pressure put on us to have this idea our kids aren't going to enjoy it unless we put enough planning into it and we put enough extras into it. Whereas they can. Our kids can still enjoy learning if it's just learning. Even if we're just sitting down and reading a good book and talking about that book, it's nothing you can really take a picture of, but it is valuable and it's actually fun. So that's the first prong. One is, let's start expecting ourselves and our kids to enjoy learning for the sake of learning. Number two is, our kids need to be able to do things that they don't find fun. That is a key element of the maturing process. Building tolerance for things that are not fun. I know about you. If you are a mom, if you are an adult watching this video, you've spent a lot of your adult life doing things that you don't find very fun. There are quite a few things that I'm pretty sure any mom could list off the top of her head that are not necessarily things that they get super excited and, you know, thinking, wow, that's going to be so fun, like going into labor or, you know, just cleaning the bathrooms. No, nobody really finds those things super enjoyable, yet they are valuable. Cleaning the bathrooms is a valuable, necessary work that we don't want to be all down about it because, oh man, I have to do something that's not fun. No, we just want to do it and do it well and find joy in a job well done, even if it's not the most fun thing. Sometimes, especially because of all the rhetoric that homeschool's all about fun and enjoying learning and, you know, building a love for learning, we can feel like we're failing at homeschool when our kid is not super intrinsically motivated to learn the times tables. But, you know, just some kids are not going to find times tables fun, or insert whatever is something necessary, important to learn, is going to benefit them for life, but just maybe isn't fun. We don't have to think, oh, I have to find a way to make it fun all the time. Sometimes you can just be like, hey, I know this isn't fun, but trust me, this is valuable. This is going to benefit you. Let's learn your times tables. Let's work on this slowly, little by little. We are going to get it in the end, but we're not going to have this idea that, oh, it's not fun. I'm not super interested in it, so therefore I'm not going to do it, because that can affect kids for a lifetime. And on the positive side, if kids learn to do valuable things, even when they're not the most fun and exciting and thrilling and interesting, when they learn to do that as kids, that skill is going to carry with them into adulthood and is going to benefit them all the times in adulthood when there's work, valuable work they need to do. It's not that interesting. Maybe it's washing dishes. Maybe it's folding laundry. But they're not going to feel like, oh, I'm going to procrastinate on that and do something that's way more fun. They're going to have that maturity and that skill to say, nope, I'm going to do that. So that's my encouragement to you, is don't be scared if your homeschool isn't fun all the time. That's normal. That's normal. Your kids are not always going to be having fun in learning. It's not always going to be their most favorite and exciting thing. There's stuff that we need to learn, and sometimes we're just going to learn it. We want to grow in our ability to see learning itself as fun. And we also want to grow in our ability to be able to just do the work without it always being so super fun. And this does not mean you don't do any of the fun activities. I just want to tell you, don't be pressuring yourself to think, oh, my kid isn't enjoying math. I need to add in something way more fun. Whereas you might need to add in something, but there's also the job of, as a parent, just encouraging your child, hey, this might not be your favorite, but I know you can do it. We can work hard. We can get through this. We can learn the skill. And praise them based on gained skills. Praise them based on work, rather than always highlighting, hey, we got to learn math through playing a game today. So we made it fun, and that was what was valuable. Whereas fun is not always the most valuable thing, but work and skill building is truly valuable for a lifetime.